In this video, we're gonna take a look at a long-awaited feature on Kittl, and that is the ability to create multiple artboards. We're gonna take a look at two ways that you can use this new feature to keep your designs organized for print on demand. All right, so there are several reasons why this new multiple artboard feature within a project is a big deal for Kittl. If you don't use Kittl, I do have other videos that I've made in the past about the functionality of Kittl and why I think it's a great tool for print-on-demand designs. I will link to those in the description if you're not familiar with Kittl. I recommend checking those out. In this video, we're going to focus in on this new feature for creating multiple artboards within a single project. Now, in the past on Kittl, even if you wanted to just create a different variation of the same design, you would have to use a new project or create a new project, and that keeps everything separate so you don't accidentally edit the original print file. But this new feature allows you to create a new artboard within a project so you can use it in multiple different ways to keep yourself organized and keep related designs together, which is pretty cool. So I'm going to start this by just creating a new project here on Kittl, and I'm going to size it for a t-shirt. So I'm going to click on POD presets, and I like to use 4500 by 5400, so we'll select that. And 300 DPI is perfect, so we'll hit create. So this is our first artboard within this project file here. I'm going to zoom out, make it a little bit smaller here so that we can actually see a little bit more what's going on. Now we can actually move this artboard around now by clicking on it. And then once there's a design in here, you might want to click right on the name of the artboard rather than accidentally click on a design element that's in it. All we have to do is click on it until you see the bounding boxes here, and then you'll be able to slide this around within your canvas of your project. So I'm gonna double click on the name here and call this one t-shirt, because for this first example, what I wanna do is show how you can keep your design organized and create different versions of the design for different sized products. So we're gonna start by creating a t-shirt design here. Then we're gonna do a separate artboard within this project, and it's gonna be for our mug. So the first thing I'm gonna do to create my design here, I'm just gonna go ahead and create a graduation themed design. I'm actually gonna use Kittl AI to create it here, because it's been doing a pretty good job for me lately, so I'm going to use that. I'm going to select the clip art style here of a mascot because that has worked pretty well for me, so I'm going to call this one. Let's see, I'm going to look for a diploma here. All right, so I'm going to see what I can get out of that prompt. All right, here's what it gave me for my prompt of a diploma wearing a cap and gown for graduation. I'm pretty happy with this. This is kind of exactly what I was hoping for. So I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of the background here with the AI background remover. Now I'm gonna go ahead and make the background of my artboard transparent. If you're looking for that and can't find the background now in the layers option in the right, all you have to do is click on the artboard to get those bounding boxes again. Click right on the name here of the artboard, and then you'll get this menu on the right. Look for the background color here, click on that. You might think you wanna drop this to zero, but if you do that, the whole artboard will go away. So leave the opacity at 100 there, change the background color and make that the opacity zero here with this slider in the corner. Now you'll have a transparent background to work with if that's what you prefer. Now I'm just gonna add some text for my design. All right, so super basic design here, but just wanted to throw something together for the example. So here is my design for 2024 graduate mom. Now I do wanna point out there are a couple things that Kittl definitely could make smoother or just improve a little bit here with this new feature. One is that the ability to click on the artboard and move it around. One thing I've noticed is right now, if you have a really large artboard like a t-shirt sized artboard, it kind of defaults to these zooms of 10 and 25%. Then when you click on the percentage, those are your two choices here, 10 and 25. As you can see, 10 is kind of small for working on the design. And the next thing it will hop to is 25. I'm using my mouse scroll wheel here to try and move around, because even when you're on this move tool, it doesn't actually move your canvas, your project area around unless you're moving an artboard around. So navigating here is a little clunky even once it is zoomed into only 25%. And now this is like too big. So it's a little clunky right now as far as the navigation standpoint goes, but I haven't found it too difficult to work with. Once you get it zoomed out a little bit, you can grab your artboard and move it to where you need it to be, and it's not too bad. But okay, so our t-shirt print file is ready to go. We could go ahead and download this and make our t-shirt. But before I do that, I know I want to sell this design on a mug at least, and maybe something else as well. So I know that I need a print file for the mug. Now I could just use the t-shirt print file because it's the right aspect ratio, it's portrait orientation, but it's got all of this blank space on the canvas really that I don't need for a mug. So I'm gonna click on the artboard again. Now, there's a couple different ways to do this. You can actually click on the artboard tool up here and then draw yourself a new artboard in a different aspect ratio, different size. Then once you do that, you can come over to the right here and actually just type in the custom size you want for this new artboard and make it the aspect ratio and the size that you want. But since I've got this print file all created already, what I can also do is just go ahead, select this artboard, and then right click on the artboard itself and click on copy, and then come over here, right click and click on paste. And this will duplicate the artboard for me. Now I can resize this, but what I want to do first, if you haven't already, make sure you select all of your layers here in this image, just get them all selected, and then hit your Control or Command G to get them all grouped. So now when you select them, you can resize them as one. I'm actually going to size this down a bit first so it doesn't get a little bit out of control for me. So now I'm going to go ahead and click this artboard here. We'll come back over to the right to our artboard settings. I'm going to make this one, let's just make it a square for ease of use. We'll do 2500 by 2500 there. All right, so now I'll scale that up to fill out the width here, and then we'll get it centered vertically. There we go, just like that. Now, double click on the name of this artboard, and I will call this one Mug. All right, now I would just keep creating these until I am done with all the designs that I intend to create. But when I'm done with this, now I could go up to the download option in the top right, click on that, and notice now you have this option for artboards. You can actually independently select which artboards you want to download. So I'll keep them all selected here. And then you still have your options for selecting. You can do SVG, you can do PNG, whatever you need to for your print-on-demand platform. Set any of the other settings that you normally would. Click on download, and then you'll get all of your files in a zip file instead of individually. So there we go. There's our two. I downloaded them both as a PNG. We've got our t-shirt file there and we've got our mug file there. Now I'm ready to go over to Printify and upload my images, create my listings, and I've got the print files all done for each product type. So that's the first suggestion I have for you to keep your designs organized in Kittl with this new multiple artboard feature. Now the second way that this becomes really helpful is if you are creating a design that you're going to repeat multiple times and just change some element like the text. So for example, I'm going to go ahead and get rid of this mug option here. Let's say I wasn't planning on selling this on a mug, but instead what I was planning on doing was creating this design and changing out some text on it and creating multiple listings using the same base design. What I would do in this case is name it based on, you know, just the general theme. So I'd name this 2024 graduate for the project. I would call my first artboard here Mom, and then I would create it just the same way I did before, and I would go ahead and copy that artboard and paste it to create my second one. I would rename this one, let's say I'm doing Dad now. I would edit my text. Now I've got my second design. Of course, reposition anything, resize if needed. Go ahead and select this one, copy that again, and we will paste another new one, and I'm going to go ahead and click on here and go, I don't know, let's just say this one's going to be Brother instead. I'm going to edit my text, and of course, as I mentioned, always do resizing or shuffling things around if you need to, if these different size texts don't work. But that's really as simple as it is. You can just keep creating multiple artboards within one project for all of these repeated designs where you're just changing some text or changing the graphic in the center or something and keeping the same text. I really like this new feature for this style of design where I'm creating multiple and they're repeated, and then I could just come in here next year and change them all to 2025. It's just nice and organized. Now, I know you can currently do things like this with other software, but this feature coming to Kittl is a big bonus, especially if you were already a Kittl user and you were waiting for this feature for a long time. Before I close out this video, let me just give you the one little solution I have for this zoom. If you hold down the Control key and then you scroll on your mouse, it will zoom in smaller increments. You'll be able to actually go, I think, in 1% increments here. So I hope they can improve that with another feature enhancement. But if you hold down the Control and scroll, you'll get a little bit better control over your zoom. So that'll do it for this video. Let me know what you think of this new feature. Let me know how you are using it to your advantage down in the comments. Hope it was helpful for you. Do me a favor and hit that thumbs up button if it was helpful. And don't forget to subscribe to the POD Insights channel. Thanks, everybody. See you next time.